Greetings in the name of Jesus. This is Brother Brian, and we are continuing to share the word of God about the life that we have received, the life of grace. Last time we were speaking that our salvation has come because of the grace of God. You know, we were explaining that it is not because of anything that we have done, but it is because of the grace of God reaching our lives, reaching every human being on earth. Hallelujah. And today we want to speak about glorifying God. You know, to live a life of grace, you have to reach a point where you glorify God. So I'm just not going to take time, just a few minutes, sharing about how you can glorify God and how it's so important for us to glorify God, giving Him the praise, giving Him the honor, and look at how, and as an individual on your daily life, you can glorify God. Hallelujah. Now we start our reading in the book of Exodus chapter 30. Start reading from verse 34. And the Bible says here, "And the Lord said to Moses, take sweet spices, spikenard and onycha and galbanum and pure frankincense. With these sweet spices there shall be equal amounts of each. You shall make of these an incense, a compound according to the art of the perfumer, salted, pure and holy. And you shall beat some of it very fine, and put some of it before the testimony in the tabernacle of meeting, where I will meet with you. It shall be most holy to you. But as for the incense which you shall make, you shall not make any for yourselves according to its composition. It shall be to you holy for the Lord." Look at that, holy for the Lord. "Whoever makes any like it to smell it, he shall be cut off from his people." Hallelujah. Now, where we have read, children of God, we read about the making of the incense that was to be offered daily in the temple of God. Now, the Bible teaches us that this incense was made in a certain way, but with spices in a specific, very specific way, that God said it should be made this way. Hallelujah. And now, the Bible explains that it was a sweet-smelling aroma to God. Every time it was offered to God, it came to God, you know, as a sweet-smelling aroma. And the Bible somewhere explains the incense, like the prayers of the saints, that the prayers of the saints, they go up as incense. Hallelujah. Now, that reaches the ears of God. That reached the heart of God. And God said to them, "This incense that is mixed for my glory, to be offered up to me, it should not be made anywhere in the land of Israel." The Bible said it should not be made. So all over Israel, there was no such kind of incense. And the Bible says that whoever made incense which was like this was to be cut off from his people. Now, why am I reading this part about incense? I want to see you to see that there are things that only belong to God and not to man. And as human beings, we must never claim them. We must never even take even a little bit of them. Hallelujah. Those things are sacred to God. Those things belong to God. And that is why today I speak about glorifying God. So the glory belongs only to God. You know, when we talk about the glory, glory to God, when we say glory to God, we are saying all the good things that have been done, it is because of God. All the honor belongs to God. All the beauty belongs to God. When we see all the beautiful things happening in our lives, it is because of God. So we say what? All these beautiful things, they come from God, and honor to Him, glory to His name. Hallelujah. So when we read about this incense in verse 38, where we have read, the Bible says, "Whoever makes any like it to smell it, he shall be cut off from his people." Now, if this person was smelling it, he was taking the place of God, because the smell of the incense was to go only to God. Hallelujah. So when we talk about glorifying God, we have to understand, saints, that we are talking about something so precious, something so important, that it belongs only to God and not to any man. Hallelujah. It might not, you know, it's not your mother, it's not your father, it's not yourself. The glory for all the wonderful things that you see goes to God. Hallelujah. So this incense was made to glorify God. God who had done what? God who had delivered them from Egypt. God who had opened the Red Sea. Now, you can't take glory for that. Even Moses could not take the glory of God. Hallelujah. They understood, even the angels of heaven, they understand that the glory belongs only to God, not to any man. In Psalm 115, the Bible says, "Not unto us, O Lord, not unto us, but to your name we give glory because of your mercy and because of your truth." Hallelujah. Now, this is such a precious point, you know, in the Psalms where David says, "Not to us, not to us." He repeats it. He says, "Not to us, not to us, but to your name be the glory." To the name of God. He says, "To you, Lord, we give the glory for all the wonderful things we do." We don't praise our parents. We don't praise our bosses. We don't even praise our intellect. Because sometimes we are so tempted to say that I am the one who has done this. I am the one who has achieved this. And forgetting that the wisdom with which we achieved whatever we achieved comes from God. The prosperity which we have, it is because of the grace and the hand of God. It is not of our own selves. It is not, you know, that is why Paul says, we are not sufficient of ourselves to brag about anything, but our sufficiency comes from God. Hallelujah. So what I'm saying to you, children of God, is that the glory must be given to God. We must exercise to give glory. We must learn to give God the glory at all things. You know, sometimes you are preaching, and as you are preaching, people come up to you and say, "Wonderful message." That is a good thing. It is not something wrong. It is a wonderful message. You are a vessel of God. But can't you as an individual remember to say, "Glory to God. He is the one who enabled me to preach." Can't you as an individual, when we say, you know, "You look so nice, you look so beautiful," you know, can't you say, "Thank you, God, that you make me beautiful." Hallelujah. And for you know, in that matter, every one of us is beautiful. We should give God glory and say, "God, thank you for my beautiful body. Thank you for my beautiful life." Hallelujah. We need to learn to give God the glory. It does not belong to any man. It belongs to God. That is why the Psalms say, "Not to us, not to us, but to God we give the glory." Hallelujah. Now, if you read your Bible in the book of Acts chapter 12, you know, starting from verse 24 or verse 20, the Bible says something so precious and so wonderful about a man called Herod. Hallelujah. Now, Herod, one day people of Israel came to him, you know, after he had killed James the apostle, and people began to praise him. He did not give God the glory. He accepted the praises of the people, not giving God the glory. Now, listen to what the Bible says here in Acts chapter 12, verse 20. It says, "Now Herod had been very angry with the people of Tyre and Sidon, but they came to him with one accord, and having made Blastus, the king's personal aide, their friend, they asked for peace because their country was supplied with food by the king's country. So on a set day, Herod, arrayed in royal apparel, sat on his throne and gave an oration to them. And the people kept shouting, 'The voice of a god and not of a man.'" Wow. "Then immediately an angel of the Lord struck him." Because why? Because he did not give glory to God. "And he was eaten by worms and died." Now, this is what happens to a man who refuses to give glory to God. The Bible says, an angel came from heaven. Why? Because he took the glory of God. He said, "All these things that are happening is because of me." And I love what the Bible says. The Bible says the people praised him. The angel did not strike him down. But when he did not give the glory to God, but took it to himself, the Bible says an angel came from heaven and struck him dead. How can we see miracles if we want to take the glory? I remember, you know, what I was reading about a great woman of God, Catherine Kuhlman. You know, she used to speak these words and say, "Lord, I promise you the glory." Can you promise God the glory? Can you say, "Father, after I have achieved all that I have achieved, I will give you the glory. I will not take even a piece of that glory. I will give you all the glory of worship. I will honor you. I will thank you. I will ascribe to you for all the greatness that I see in my life." We are still going to see great things in our lives, but the question is, are you going to give God the glory? Are you going to stand and testify that it was the Lord who did this? It was the Lord who did this for me. Hallelujah. Now, in the book of Revelation and throughout the scriptures, really, we see whenever men meet angels, they bow before the angels. But the angels understand the order of heaven. Angels refuse to take that glory. They say, "We are servants like you. As a man of God, you can't allow for people to kneel to you after they have been healed. You can't allow people to, you know, praise you for the healings. Why can't you point their eyes to Jesus? Hallelujah. Point them to Jesus, because it is the power of God through you that is working. So we need to learn continually to give God the glory. Sing songs of glory to Him. Every time we see a miracle, we need to say the glory belongs to God. Hallelujah. Now in John 17 verse 4, this is the last part. I said when we started that, how can I give God glory on a day-to-day basis? Hallelujah. Listen to the words of Jesus in John chapter 17 verse 4. The Bible says, I have glorified you on earth. I have finished the work which thou gavest me to do. Hallelujah. Now, if you want to glorify God daily, you know, it's beyond, this one is beyond just singing. It's beyond saying words of praise. It's beyond saying God healed me. No. The high form of glorifying God is when you daily meditate on how to serve God. And knowing what you have to do, then you serve Him. Hallelujah. You work for Him. You glorify Him. You do a service to God. Hallelujah. Not only in the church, but with your life. You use your life to glorify God. You do that assignment which He has put in your spirit. Hallelujah. It does not matter whether it is in business, whether it is in ministry, whether it is in the church. It does not matter where it is. But everywhere you are, finish the work that God has given you. Do the work that God has given you. Jesus does not say, I've glorified you, I did some other things. No, He says, what you told me to do is what I did. So the person who glorifies God is the one who does the very thing that God wants to be done. He does not do His own bidding. He does not do what He wants to do. But He only does the things that God has commanded Him to do. Hallelujah. So give your life daily to glorify God. Do those things which the Holy Spirit tells you to do on a daily basis. Hallelujah. And remember, it is because of God's grace that we are able to do everything that we are doing. Hallelujah. So may the Lord give you, you know, wisdom to serve Him. May the Lord give you strength to serve Him and to glorify Him on earth. Hallelujah. That is why we are still here. We are here to glorify God and to honor Him, for He has done great things in our lives. Be blessed in Jesus' name. Greetings in the name of Jesus.